On October 22, 1975, an unmanned Soviet spacecraft accomplished a soft landing on Venus and relayed the first image from another planet's surface back to Earth. Rocks and rounded stones were scattered all around the landing location as seen in the photos. Additionally, the spacecraft transmitted information about the nearest planetary neighbor's atmosphere, soil, and dense cloud cover. The official statement released by the Soviet press agency TASS stated that the landing vehicle operated for 53 minutes on the surface of Venus after a 4.5-month, 186 million-mile voyage. But what did the Soviet probes capture on the surface of Venus? Let's find out. Hello everyone, welcome back to Elon Musk Evolution, where we bring you the most recent news about Elon Musk and his multi-billion-dollar companies, space news, and the latest science and technology. But before we begin, make sure you subscribe to our channel and click the bell icon so you don't miss any of our amazing videos. Only 4 spacecraft have ever brought back pictures of Venus's surface. The neighboring planet doesn't make it simple. Its scorching heat and crushing pressure would rapidly wipe out any lander. Our sole photographs of Venus's surface were taken by 4 Venera missions from the Soviet Union between 1975 and 1982. The Veneras, which is Russian translates to Venus, scan the surface in all directions to build up panoramic photographs of their surroundings. These views of a planet that may have previously resembled Earth before experiencing catastrophic climate change displayed yellow skies and fragmented, bleak landscapes that were both foreign and familiar. It was unclear whether the automated probe, known as Venera 9, had stopped working after that time, but that was the implication. It was also unknown whether Soviet scientists hoped that after receiving transmissions from 2 previous probes for 23 and 50 minutes, their spacecraft would be more durable this time. The landing, especially the surprisingly clear photo that was delivered, was described by the press as making Soviet scientists thrilled. The 3rd Soviet spacecraft to softly touch down on Venus is Venera 9. Venera 7 and 8 both arrived in December 1970 and July 1972, although they only briefly aired. Venus's surface is studded with mountains and volcanoes that ascend towards sulfuric acid clouds and has a hellish temperature of almost 465 degrees Celsius. The atmosphere is under extremely high barometric pressure, which describes this intolerably hot planet. Fast-moving winds are sweeping clouds across a murky yellow sky, giving the impression of being 1,500 meters underwater. Venus might as well be a holding area for rovers and other exploration-oriented spacecraft. Mission lengths are measured in minutes rather than months when we send our landers to perish, as a result of the unfriendly and harsh conditions. It is simple to understand why Venus, or more specifically its heat, ruins electrical equipment. Before the Soviets focused on Venus and started their exploration, there was little information available about this planet. What was discovered on Venus? Does life exist on Venus in any form? What mysteries did the Soviet Union keep hiding about the planet? Let's investigate. Many people think of Mars as our planet's younger sibling due to its towering distance of 34 million miles from the Earth. However, Venus is much larger and heavier than Earth and is located 25 miles closer to Earth at the closest point in its orbit. While the size of the red planet is roughly half that of Earth, Venus is almost the same size, with the exception of a Venusian moon. It seems that at one point in their past, Venus and the Earth were twin sisters. Even the assumption that Venus might have once contained water some 700 million years ago has been brought up in a report written in 2016 by NASA scientist Michael Way and his group. If this is the case, Earth might currently be moving in the same direction as Venus. In spite of this, there are still certain differences between Earth and Venus, knowledge that was mostly discovered as a result of the Soviet Union's studies on the planet. Because the US launched the Pioneer and Voyager probes in the 1970s to research the outer planets, it is normal and appropriate to hail them as historic interplanetary accomplishments. This is partially attributable to the Pioneer plaque and the Voyager Golden Record, both of which suit the theory that they might someday be found by extraterrestrials. Furthermore, it will make it easier for them to blend in with society. Robotic explorers get a lot of attention and frequently get given human features just like human explorers do. Examples of this include the Viking landers and the Sojourner, Spirit, Opportunity, and Curiosity rovers. On the other hand, the extravagant Soviet Venus investigation efforts are all but forgotten now. In the late 1950s, the Soviet Union began to create many Venus probes. They built and ran the interplanetary spaceship as part of the Venera program at the dawn of the space age for close to 30 years, performing some feats that are still astounding by today's standards. Early in the 1960s, the Cold War was in full swing, and the space race was in full effect. The Soviet Union was eager to get as many firsts as possible in all areas of spaceflight. Compared to the US at the time, they could transport heavier cargoes. The ability to build and launch larger manned and unmanned spacecraft was made possible by this. A sophisticated telemetry system and four-stage rockets were also used by the Soviets to launch missions to the inhospitable inner planets. With only 184 pounds, Venera 1, the first probe in the Soviet Venus mission series, weighed an astounding 1,400 pounds. The Venera 1 probe was more heavier than the first satellite, Sputnik 1. In addition to having a magnetometer, Geiger counters, and micrometeorite detectors, the device, which resembled a Dalek from Doctor Who, was spin-stabilized to maintain a constant temperature for the equipment. Like many of its descendants, the probe's interior was pressurized to just over one atmosphere with nitrogen gas. However, the original Venera 1 probe was never able to escape Earth's orbit, and the second attempt, which was launched on February 12, 1961, failed to reach Venus. Built to fly past Venus at a distance of around 62,000 miles, Venera 2 was very identical to Venera 1, and it would record data and transmit it back to Earth. The probe completed its flyby on February 27, 1966, and came within about 15,000 miles, but it also overheated and was never heard from or seen again. Venera 2 might have fallen apart either before or after it flew by the distant world. However, nobody is sure yet. Venera 3 through 6 were the following four probes developed by the Soviets to more thoroughly study the atmosphere of our hostile neighbor. These probes, which normally weighed 900 kilograms, or roughly 2,000 pounds each, were equipped with a variety of equipment as well as a detachable pod known as a descent module. The descent module was supplied with a distinct set of instrumentation. These tools comprised thermometers, a barometer, a radar altimeter, and gas analyzers. However, not all of these investigations were fruitful. On March 1, 1966, Venera 3 smashed into Venus instead of landing there as planned, becoming the first spacecraft to strike another planet in history. In the course of its gentle descent through Venus's dense atmosphere on October 18, 1967, Venera 4 collected data for more than 90 minutes. In addition, it found that there was no global magnetic field and that the amounts of carbon dioxide in the atmosphere were relatively high. The intense heat and pressure of the planet eventually caused it to expire. The Venera 5 and 6 missions, which parachuted through Venus's atmosphere on May 16 and 17, 1969, were both successful and sent data for more than 50 minutes, as was to be expected. With the help of these probes, the romantic idea that Venus was an earthly paradise was shattered. By further describing the planet's atmospheric chemistry and equipping it with powerful weapons, it can resist the terrible circumstances on the surface. A more ambitious descent module was included in Venera 7 and was designed to settle on Venus without incident. The flights that took out on August 17, 1970 met with some success on December 15, 1970. The lander was successful in reaching the surface, but only after its parachute tore, sending it plummeting faster than expected for more than 30 minutes before slamming into the surface at about 38 miles per hour. Even though Venera 7 was initially thought to have failed, it was able to transmit helpful data for a short while. The temperature of the surface, which the lander measured at approximately 900 degrees Fahrenheit, would be almost as hot as a brick pizza oven. Using data from the probe's pressure sensor, which failed during the descent, researchers were able to calculate a surface pressure of approximately 92 bars. The pressure is about the same as what you would feel if you were more than a half mile 900 meters underwater. Unexpectedly, Venera 8 was able to provide some crucial geochemical insights that strengthen Venus's claim to be Earth's sister planet. Despite the fact that we are unable to view Venus's surface from space, Venera 8 produced several fascinating discoveries about the planet's surface visibility. Venera 8 was the second man-made object to land on Venus on March 27, 1972, making it not only the first landing on another planet that was completely successful. In order to measure the atmosphere and surface of Venus, the Venera 8 spacecraft was launched into orbit. After 118 days, it docked with the planet. The measurements of the atmosphere of Venus taken by Venera 7, which, despite difficulties with its landing, was able to indicate that the atmosphere was 97 carbon dioxide, were to be confirmed by Venera 8. The surface temperature was 887 degrees Fahrenheit, and there was also a 9.0 MPa pressure recorded. As a result of these findings, it became immediately evident that Venus lacks water and is not suitable for human habitation. Venera 7 and 8 both verified the measurements they had taken. Venera 8 photometer, however, found an unexpected thing because of its rather calm landing. Venus's atmosphere actually had visibility on its surface that was comparable to Earth's on a cloudy day. And though it was difficult to see through the cloudy Venusian atmosphere to the planet's surface, it was still feasible to see about a kilometer in either direction. Engineers working on the Venera projects noticed clouds at a considerable height in the sky and realized that if Venera 8 arrived, it would be feasible to capture photos on the surface. As a result, Venera 9 made history in 1975 when it became the first lander to take pictures of the surface of a planet other than Earth. During the 50 minutes and 11 seconds it took to relay data, Venera 8 also measured the concentrations of thorium, potassium, and uranium in Venus's surface material. These elements are trace elements on Earth after landing, which means they are present in trace concentrations and are found in bezels like those in Hawaii or mid-ocean ridges. The missions from the Soviet Union that are best recognized today are Venera 9 through Venera 12, which each weighed about 5,000 kilograms or 11,000 pounds. The main reason for this is that their landers were equipped with cameras that could take photos of the ground immediately. According to Venera 9, the temperature reached 905 degrees Fahrenheit, which is more than twice the melting point of tin. At such temperatures, conventional radio electronics would melt. The paper would catch fire, and it's likely that the probe would come into contact with pools of molten lead. Due to their wide-angled optics, the early photographs taken by Venera 9 and 10 are frightening. They depict an arid and rocky alien country that reaches out beyond the horizon in sharp, clear, and spherically deformed images. However, the images also captured the lander's edges, which revealed its distinctively Soviet design. And that ends today's episode. What do you think of the planet Venus? Do you believe that the Soviets are hiding something? Let us know in the comment box below. Please subscribe and don't forget to like today's video. We'll see you in the next video. Thanks for watching.